All right, now we're going to make a two-color stamp. So we're talking about a stamp that you can take a piece of rubber, you put ink on it, put it down. Then you take another stamp, you put a different color ink on it, put it down. The two stamps, the two rubber stamps, when combined, equals a two-color image. Okay? So, in order to do that, first you have to understand how big is the stamp. You know, you have to measure it. And I'll give you the settings for right now. Let's say our stamp is going to be 4 by 2. We'll close that out. Okay, let's design our stamp what we want it to look like. And we'll put, like, just for this example, stamp. And I want capital letters. Okay, we'll just make the word stamp. Again, this could be anything. It's just an example. But I'm going to be using text as my example. So if we wheel mouse up here, we can make our text any size. But we can also go like this and grab it with the black arrow. I like this font, but I really don't like it in the sense that it needs to be thicker in order to have an outline. So I'm going to go to text and font, and I'll look for something that has a lot of space on the inside. And you'll know when you have it. Ah, there's a good one. Let's go with this one. This one's got a lot of space. Let's apply it. Let's drag that out. Stamp. Okay, now on the inside of the stamp, I would like to have it so it's white or a color. Let's say a color. So in this case, I have a fill, and the fill color, let's say it's going to be green. And let's make a stroke. And let's change this so the stroke is pretty big, but not too big. That's not too bad, but I don't like how it's getting these weird lines. Sometimes you're going to have to just type it in. Right about there. Perfect. Okay, so in order for a stamp to work, it has to be in a total abstract way of thinking. Everything you see here has to be reversed in white or black. Okay, and anytime you see white, it's going to be the color that you have. So it's, you have to open your mind to think inverse of what you're normally used to. So first off, let's go to layers. And let's make a layer. Layer below the current. And we'll call this background. Okay, and we'll call this one green, and we'll have black here in a second. So the first thing we need to do is convert all these to a path. Okay, now all these letters are joined together, so we're going to have to go like this, break apart. And object ungroup. So now each one of these letters are separate entities in the fact that they also have to be break apart. Oh, hold on here. First we have to go like this. Stroke to path. So every one of these letters has to be stroke to path. Good. Now the centers of these centers have to be separated from themselves in order to be green again. And this is the fun part, okay? So what we do here is first let's look at the problem in the outline. So here's the whole thing, and what I need to do is get that center out of there. So if I break apart, I get the center of the center. These are the green. Making the outside edge the one I need for the black. So what I'm going to do is sit here and break these apart, each one of these. Just like that. For this one, however, the one with the centers, I'm going to combine just these two paths. So I'm going to combine those back. So this one and this one. And then I'm going to take the outside ones. I'll make a new layer above current. I'm going to call this one black. Okay. So, grab the big one, the outside edge, and I'm going to move that up to black. So I'm going to do that by going into layer, move selection to a layer above. You can also hit shift page up. Let's turn that one off. There we go. This little guy goes there too. Shift page up. Okay, so now we got our green, and let's just colorize this again just to get ourselves acquainted to it. Let's put green here, and let's go view it. So there's green, which would go above black, and there's black. Sweet. And look, it rounded up these little corners here too. So now it looks better. Okay, now, here's what's going to really blow your mind. So now that we have this, I'm going to separate the videos into two videos. The next, this is how you separate text from outline and fill. And the next one would be show you how to set up a stamp using it.